Hi, my name is Matthew, and I work as a support technician here at SocialEngine. Today, I'm going to guide you through how to install plugins so that you and your members can get the most out of your SocialEngine experience. Before we begin, there are a few things that you should have already completed. First is that you have already installed a licensed copy of SocialEngine on your web server or in your development environment. Second, you'll need to have downloaded all the plugin files that you wish to install. Also, there's a good chance that you'll need your FTP connection information, so have that handy. Also, please note that it doesn't matter if your plugins were purchased directly from SocialEngine or from one of the many third-party developers, as the steps for installing a plugin will be the same. To begin, the first thing you'll need to do is log into your site. Then, navigate to the admin area. Once in the admin area, you'll see the Manage Plugins button. Click this. You are now in the SocialEngine Package Manager. Here, you can see which packages and plugins have already been installed, as well as what versions they are. This is also where you can choose to enable or disable a plugin if you find you no longer want it in the future. To begin installing your plugins, click the Install New Packages link at the top of the page. And now you should see an Add Package link. When you click this, a File Chooser window will come up and you should navigate to where you saved your plugin files that you downloaded earlier. You are able to upload more than one file at a time by selecting multiple files in the chooser. To select multiple files, just hold the Command key while you click if you use a Mac, or hold the Control key while you click if you're using Windows. Once you have selected all the files you want to upload, click the Open button. And now, you should see the progress of all the files you selected start to upload. Once the uploads have been completed, SocialEngine will automatically extract them. Some common problems people run into while uploading their plugins include the 2038 error. If, after your file uploads, you see the text, Error 2038, there is a good chance that your server has the Apache Mod Security or Mod Security 2 module enabled. In this case, you will need to contact your hosting provider and let them know that you will need this disabled, because this is a system requirement for SocialEngine to function properly. For further instructions on how to correctly set your folder permissions, please see the SocialEngine installation tutorial video. Once your plugins have properly uploaded and extracted, you can now click the Continue button. The next step will show you the actions that will take place during the installation process, as well as run checks for necessary dependencies, such as folder permissions, and making sure that you have any dependent modules already installed. Much like during the initial installation process, any items you see in yellow boxes can be ignored, but items in red boxes mean that you will have to take care of that issue before you can continue. After clicking the Continue button again, you'll see the FTP info screen. It is a good idea to select FTP or FTPS from the drop-down menu, and enter in your FTP username and password. You can leave the host as 127.0.0.1, since your server will technically be talking to itself. You also don't have to adjust the FTP path as long as you select Search for SocialEngine. When this is checked, the installer will automatically find where to put the necessary files. Also, remember to check the sftp box if you'll be using an sftp connection. Then, click Continue. If your FTP connection fails, the first thing you should try is to change the FTP host to the host address that your hosting provider gave you. And if that doesn't work, you can go to the FTP connection type drop-down box and select None, and you'll still be able to proceed with the installation. This is sometimes necessary when a hosting provider prevents PHP scripts from making FTP connections for security reasons. When you click the Continue button, you'll see a count of how many files that will be copied during this installation. Then you can click Continue to proceed. Next, you will get a confirmation letting you know that all the files have been successfully placed. Again, click Continue to proceed. On the next screen, you'll see a count of all the MySQL database queries that were made and that they succeeded. Now click Finalize Installation. You have now successfully completed installing your plugins. On a very important note, if you initially had a trial version of SocialEngine and this is your first time adding a plugin after purchasing it, you must now do this entire procedure over again. This is to ensure that all the encrypted files have now been overwritten by unencrypted PHP files. A common question I get as a support technician is, how do I remove a plugin if I don't want it anymore? In this situation, we highly recommend that you do not delete any files from your server. Many plugins also alter SocialEngine's core code, and removing the plugin's code will leave gaps, making your copy of SocialEngine vulnerable to erratic bugs and dysfunctions. So if you decide that you do not want a plugin anymore, go to your package manager and simply click the disable button. Doing this will remove the functionality of that plugin. Thanks for watching this tutorial, and be sure to keep your eye out for more like it coming soon.